literature and philosophy and yoga being confirmed upon the title Shailaputri. Now over to Dr. Kavita Ghosh to present her speech on Bhavatita Dhyana and Yoga Nidra. Bhavatita Dhyana and Yoga Nidra. Over to Dr. Kavita Ghosh.
Thank you so much, Professor Arya. Thank you so much. First of all, I want to congratulate my prior orator, Professor Tapti. It was a wonderful session. I want to congratulate from the core of my heart, and it was really nice. Thank you so much for this nice session. And then I'm very thankful to Professor Pramod Kumar Das sir and organizing committee of philosophy family who invited me again for this talk on Yoga Nidra and Bhavatita Dhyana. And at that time the schedule was different, so we have decided to talk about Yoga Nidra and Bhavatita Dhyana. But these both topics are so wider, and it is very difficult to cover both topic in this short period. So I would like to talk about Yoga Nidra in this session, and we will think about Bhavatita Dhyana in another session when it will be possible to join. So I would like to focus on Yoga Nidra. So again, I'm thankful and very good evening all of you. And there are so many senior professors in this session, and I'm really very lucky to attend the session and listen to you people. And it was really a nice deliberation and nice discussion also. So I would like to try say something about Yoga Nidra in yogic system. First of all, I want to share the outlines of my lecture. So I think it will be interesting to understanding the Raj Yogi concept of personality before other ideas. And then we should move toward understand the Upanishadic concept of personality. Then we will understand about the concept of Antahkaran in yoga philosophy. And then the place of Manas in Chitta or Antahkaran. Then the place of Manas in Chitta or Antahkaran, and after that we will move toward the proper understanding of stages or avastha of Chitta, and then we should understand the concept of Yoga Nidra properly, and it is must to understand avastha of Chitta of Yoga Nidra during Yoga Nidra, and the place of Yoga Nidra in yogic literature, it is also must to understand. And then we will move toward the process of Yoga Nidra or practice of Yoga Nidra orally, because this is a online platform, so it is not possible to make a practice properly, but I'll deliver the technique, and you people get the technique, then you could practice it, and you could get benefited with it. So after that, I'll analyze the importance of happiness and health and well-being in the life of human being, and then after all, I will discuss the role of Yoga Nidra in well-being. So these are the outline of my lecture. So first of all, we should understand the Raj Yogi concept of personality. Friends, you know that there are two two components, two tattvas in our personality. The first one is prakriti, which is matter. And the second one is purusha or consciousness, ultimate consciousness. When these both got combined, then mahat ahankaras get produced, and the production of ahankaras, sattva, rajas and tamas, are various. There are various products of these particular components. Five gyanindriyas, eyes, nose, ears, tongue, skin, and five karmendriyas, hands, feet, mouth, sexual organ and anus, and one manas. But manas is not mind. It is very important to understand that manas is not mind. So these are the product of sattva guna. And after that, the second component of second guna is rajas. Rajas is responsible for the action in our personality. It lead to what? Activities. It provoke these both sattva and tamas to be active. And the third one is tamas. It resulted in five tanmatras, roop, ras, gandha, shabd, sparsh, and five mahabhutas, agni, jal, prithvi, vayu, and akash. This is the Rajyogi concept of personality. So now the question is that what is antahkaran, which is very important, which is very important component of our personality, that is antahkaran. See, one manas, which is chetan, which is chit, and one buddhi, which is jad, and ahankara, sattva, rajas, and tamas. These three are the components of antahkaran. There are three gunas, which is sattva, rajas and tamas, I have already said to you. And the color of sattva is white, and jnana, viveka, dharma and vairagya, etc. are the activities or are the criterias of or are the expressions of sattva, we may say. The second one is rajas, and the color of rajas is red, calm, krodh, lobh, moh, etc. are the expressions of rajas. The third one is tamas, and the color of tamas is black, and agyan, ahankar, and laziness, it means alasya. These are the expressions of tamas. So I think it is very clear that what is the role of three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas in antahkaran, and what is the role of manas, what is the role of chit, what is the role of buddhi? These are the questions. So let me try to discuss the place of manas in chitta or antahkaran. Chit or chetan, component of personality, this is the component deal with emotions, sensation, suffering of a person, and this is the master of panch gyanindriyas, and this is the master of panch karmendriyas. So the gyan and karma depend on it directly or indirectly. So now the question is that which are the stages of atman or what are the avasthas of chitta or manas? According to Mandukya Upanishad, there are four stages of atman or consciousness. The first one is jagrat avastha, that is aware stage of our personality, manas. The second one is swapna, that is dreaming. The third one is susupti, that is sleeping. And the fourth one is turiya. Beyond all these stages of manas, this is the highest or ultimate stage of Atman, and this is the stage during the moksha, during the kaivalya, and as Professor Tapti was saying that moksha is ultimate bliss. So this is the stage of Atman during the moksha or kaivalya. That is called Turiya Avastha or Turiya stage of Manas. So whatever Indian literature is saying about it, according to Mandukya Upanishad, the Vishwa is Vyakta Swarup of Atman and Atman is Brahma. And Brahma is word derived from Sanskrit dhatu brih, which means vriddhi. There are four pada of Brahma, and first one is Vaishvanar. The second Vaishvanar is a Jagrat, which is Vahispragya. The second one is Tejas, that is Swapna or Antapragya with Sukshma Sharir. And the third one is Pragya, which is Sushupti, and fourth one is Turiya, as I already said. That the total nirodha of antah and bahya vishayas is leading toward the Turiya. So I think this is very clear that there are four stages of our manas or chitta or our antahkarana, and the avasthas leads a person toward vikshipta avastha, mood avastha, kshipta avastha, ekagra avastha, and nirudha avastha. Vikshipta avastha is full of tamas, and it has the expressions like agyan, avairagya, avivek, andhakar, all these things, idleness, laziness. These are the expressions of vikshipta. Second one is mood. And mood is full of rajas and tamas. This is mixture of rajas and tamas. The third one is kshipta. This is again the mixture of rajas and tamas, but rajas will be more dominating than sattva. This is kshipta avastha. And the third one is ekagra avastha. This is a very unique avastha, and this is full of sattva. It leads towards vairagya, jnan, and dhriti, kshama, aste. All these kind of expressions are derived from ekagra avastha, and it is full of sattva. The fourth avastha is nirudh, and this is beyond all these. Chetan without influencing gunas, that is called yogas chitta vritti nirodha by Patanjali. Yogas chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. There are four terms in this definition of yoga, and yogas chitta vritti nirodha. Chitta is antahkaran. Yoga is the ultimate aim of life, which we get with Turiya avastha. And vrittis are five: avidya, asmita, ragdvesh, and avinivesh. And the total cessation of these chitta vritti is called yoga chitta vritti nirodha. This is the yogic concept of personality. And after that, we should understand the Upanishadic concept of personality. There are panch koshas in our personality. First one is annamay kosh. Second one is pranamay, then manomay, and then vijnanamay, and then anandamay. These are five seeds of our personality, and these are like the onion levels. These are the five levels of our personality. First one is anmay, second one is pranmay, third one is manomay, vijnanmay, and anandmay. This is very, very important to understand the Hatha yogic concept of personality. And there are so many nadis in our body, Ira and Pingala and Sushumna. Three nadis are very important in our personality, and chakras, seven chakras are also there, and these are the components of our personality. I'm not saying the body, components of our personality. So now we should understand that what is yoga nidra and what to do with yoga nidra, and why the practice of yoga nidra is very important for the person. So what is yoga nidra? This is a combination of two words, yoga and nidra. The nidra with ultimate goal of yoga, and this is the process of hatha yoga. Yoga nidra is the process of hatha yoga. Hatha yoga, ha and tha. There are two alphabets, ha and tha. Ha is right nostril and tha is left. Ha is left nostril and tha is right nostril. And these are the ina and pingala also nadis. And in between of our personality, there is sushumna nadi. So this is a hatha yogic process. Yoga nidra is totally hatha yogic practice, and there are so many psychotherapists who is using this process for psychotherapy also, and they are regularly telling that this is our innovation, but this is not the innovation of Western world. I want to according to Swami Satyananda Saraswati, who is very famous devotee and yogi, it's a nidra sleep with deep consciousness. It means it is a process which leads a person toward the feeling of deep consciousness, and it's the process which leads a person from annamaya kosh to anandamaya kosh. Annamaya kosh to anandamaya kosh. Annamaya kosh is this is the body. Annamaya kosh is body, and then pranamaya, manomaya, these are the levels of our personality. So it leads the consciousness from annamaya toward the anandamaya kosh. The rishis follows an ahat sen of Bhagwan Vishnu, which is yoga nidra on kundali of Seshnaga in Kshir Sagar, and the rishis felt samipya of Bhagwan Vishnu through the process of yoga nidra, and they got blessed with ultimate knowledge in this process of yoga nidra without mediating any indriya or any indriya, including manas. So the rishis leads their consciousness in various stages of yoga through yoga nidra, and they lead themselves to the puri at ultimate phase of consciousness. This is the historical background of yoga nidra, and now we should understand that how to practice yoga nidra. The prior instructions are there. This is must to practice yoga nidra in guidance of a trained yoga guru. So the person who wants to practice should be devoted to a guru. This is must. If not possible, then anyone can practice it with a recording videos of any reputed institution of yoga, but it is must to be conscious during the practice. We should not take a sleep. This is must. The person should not go to sleep during the practice, and one should wear comfortable dress during the practice. The room for the practice should be quiet, calm, full of light and pure fresh air. One can do it with do it in a park too, and in a open place too, but it should be quite calm and full of light and pure fresh air. In their practice, while we practicing in hall, there should be a proper distance of between two person, two practitioners. I think about 2 meters between each person. It should be practiced during 4 to 6 a.m. In Brahma Muhurt. This is very important. And the practice of yoga nidra during the Brahma Muhurt resulted in various spiritual benefits too. So this is very important to practice yoga nidra during Brahma Muhurt. And the second time of yoga nidra is 8 to 10 p.m. before going to bed. It should be Then after 1 to 2 hours taking meals, and if not possible, then it should be done before meals. So I mean to say that the stomach should be totally empty during the practice. Now, how much time we should get for the practice of yoga nidra? This is the question. And we should do it for 20 to 40 minutes required for the practice according to the manasik situation or mental situation or a need of a person. So this is very important to practice yoga nidra between 20 to 40 minutes. So what should we do before practicing yoga nidra? This is the question. First of all, we should practice shavasana. One should take a mat and lay down on back, and the hands and feet should be straight. Means one should not fold these from joints, and one should maintain a gap of 1 to 1.5 feet in legs and hands. And hands should be like this. This. Hands should be like this. The palms should be upward, and one should close eyes. One should be free from any kind of physical or mental tension or stress during the practice. The body should be straight line during the practice. These are the questions for practicing yoga nidra. One should be focused on the rhythm of inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. This is very important, and we should focus on our inhaling process and exhaling process. The person should not be forceful during the practice. These are the instructions during yoga nidra, and the person should be repeat the shubh sankalpas. I'll do good. I'll be positive during the practice. I'll be adhyatmik. I'll be positive. I'll be conscious one. I'll be happy. I'll be healthy. I'll be a pure conscious one. These are the sankalpas during which we need to repeat again and again during the practice of yoga nidra. And now, avartan is very important. Avartan of chetna is must during the practice of yoga nidra, and the sithilikaran is also necessary during the practice of yoga nidra. The pratik darshan is must. Pratik darshan means the symbols like flowers, temples, mahapurushas, devatas, sadhus and gurus, and or any loving one, pitri, and any beloved one, the mother, father, all these which you love, you can take a symbol of them, and you can practice it with these symbols like devatas, guru and all this. So now we should understand the 8 steps of yoga nidra, 8 charanas of yoga nidra. The first one is prasupti. The second one is shithilikaran through shavasana. The third one is sankalpa. The fourth one is chetana sancharan, bahirnyas and antarnyas. The fifth one is mansik nadi shodhan. The sixth one is kalpanik chalad drishya darshan. And next is sankalp should be repeated thrice during this step. Sankalp should be repeated thrice during this step. And the next one is samapti or samapan. Now, what is shithilikaran, what is prasupti, what is sankalp, what is chetana sancharan, what is mansik nadi shodhan, kalpanik taladrisa darshan? Prasupti is the deep relaxation of our body and mind. This is deep relaxation. We should lay down in shavasana, and we should close our eyes, and we should focus on our inhale and exhale, and we should feel the rhythm of these inhaling and exhaling process. We should focus on the music of our prana. This is the music of prana. We should feel that. And this is the process of prasuti. This is the process of shithilikaran. This is the process of total relaxation through savasana. We should lay down like a dead body. We should feel the rhythm of our inhaling and exhaling process. We should feel the music of our pranas. We should feel these things during the relaxation of our body and mind. This is prasuti and shithilikaran through shavasana. Then the next step is sankalpa. Sankalpa is a place with us. Sankalpa is a place with ourselves. Sankalpa is a place with our consciousness. That is ultimate. I'll be a positive one. I'll be a pure one. I'll be a spiritual one. I'm a pure consciousness. These are the sankalpas. And I'll be healthy. I'll be happy. I'll be blissful. I'll be beneficial for the society. I'll be helpful for the society. These are the sankalpas during the step sankalpa of yoga nidra. And the second one is chetana sancharan. This is our manas who repeat the sankalpas and who repeat the chetana sancharan. That is ultimate consciousness. We can move our consciousness, the organs of our body, like our thumb, our fingers, and our all body. First of all, we should move the chetana from left side, then right side, then front side, then back side. We should move the consciousness according our sankalpas, and we should focus our consciousness on the various bindus, various points of our personality. This is chetana sancharan, and bahirnyas and antarnyas are in between. What is bahirnyas? Bahirnyas is kshipra chalat darshan, or moving of chetana, which I have earlier said, that kshipra chalat darshan, or moving of chetanas. Round and round we should move our chetana on various points of our personality. So we should move the consciousness or our chetana on the right side of our personality, on the left side of our personality, on the front side of our personality, and back side of our personality. This is bahirnyas. The second one is antarnyas. Antarnyas means we should focus and move our consciousness on various chakras of our personality. Seven chakras are there: Mooladhar, Swadhisthan, Manipur, Anahat, Vishuddhi, Ajna, and Sahasrara. These are the seven chakras in our body. Exactly, chakras are not solar plexus. Several persons say that these chakras are solar plexus, but I'm not agree with them. These are the energy point of our personality, and we should focus on these during yoga nidra, and we should move our consciousness round and round on these chakras. So this is antarnyas. This is called antarnyas. After that, we should do mansik nadi sodhan. What is mansik nadi sodhan? The mansik nadi sodhan is a shodhan or purification of ira and pingala nadis. Ira nadi is this left, and pingala nadi is this right. These are the nostrils which belongs to ira and pingala, and there is an important nadi in our personality within our sushumna. This is sushumna in our spinal cord. This is called sushumna. So there are three important nadis in our personality: ira, pingala, and sushumna. We should purify our ira and pingala with anulom vilom pranayam, but it should be मानसिक, इट शुड बी मेंटल. वी शुड नॉट डू अनुलोम विलोम एट दैट टाइम, बट वी शुड इमेजिन दैट वी आर डूइंग अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम ड्यूरिंग दिस योग निद्रा प्रोसेस. सो वी शुड ऑफ द प्रोसेस ऑफ इमेजिनेशन ऑफ अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम बाय लेफ्ट नॉस्ट्रिल एंड राइट नॉस्ट्रिल, एंड वी शुड इमेज, वी शुड बी इमेजिनेटिव, इनहेल विथ लेफ्ट नॉस्ट्रिल एंड काउंट 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1 to 27, वी शुड काउंट इन अवर मनस, एंड देन वी शुड बी इमेजिनेटिव ड्यूरिंग द इनहेल विथ राइट नॉस्ट्रिल एंड काउंट 27 to 1, रिवर्स काउंटिंग, इट शुड बी रिवर्स काउंटिंग. And we should be imaginative during all this process. We shouldn't do anulom vilom, but we should opt the imagination of anulom vilom by our left and right nostril. And we should count 1 to 27 in our manas. Mental counting, it means not verbal counting, but mental counting. And we should count from 1 to 27, then we should be back. We should be aware about reverse counting 27 to 1. It was manasik anulom vilom, and then the next step is kalpanik chalad drishya darshan. Yog nidra is beyond the reason. You see, this is not for only Hindus, or this is not for only Bharatiyas, Indians. This is beyond the religion, beyond the race, and beyond the community. Anyone can get benefited with this yoga nidra process for the physical, mental, and spiritual balance and health and happiness and well-being. This is very must to understand. The yoga nidra is beyond the religion, race, and community. But this is the innovation of ancient Indian or Bharatiya culture. This is originated from that. This is not a new one. This is the process which our rishis, our munis, our practitioners, our gurus practiced during the samadhis. So this is very important to understand that this is a heritage of Indian culture. But we can practice it beyond the religion, race, and community, because it is very beneficial for all the person. For this is a this is very very good practice for all human beings. So we should opt it for our well-being beyond the religion, race, and community. This is very important. Anyone can practice it with their own imagination, like Bhagavan, like Om, like Pranav, like Vaheguru, like Buddha, like God, like Allah. So there is no limitation to be imaginative during this practice. We can imagine, we can imagine according our faith. We can imagine according our religion. We can imagine according our community. So this is very important to practice beyond the religion, race, and community. I'm repeating again and again, because this is very important to practice yoga nidra for every person, because these are the days of tension. These are the days of mental stress. These are the days of work pressure, and various type of tensions are there in our life. So we should be relaxed with yoga nidra, the practice of yoga nidra. And in ancient time, the gurus or rishis are using to Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Ram, Krishna, Devi, Durga, Kali, Lakshmi, Saraswati, etc. for the dhyan or yoga nidra. This is very important. And we can also imagine the historical persons too, like Mahatma Gandhi, और लाइक सुभाष चंद्र बोस और लाइक एनी इंडियन हीरो और एनी एनी अदर पर्सन विच वी लाइक. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो इमेजिन ट्रीज, वी कैन ऑल्सो इमेजिन फ्लावर्स, वी कैन ऑल्सो इमेजिन एनिमल्स, एल्व्स, सनराइज, रिवर, वैली, फॉरेस्ट, माउंटेन, सी, any other kind of paridrishya, drishya, any other kind of natural things we can imagine during the practice. So this is very clear. And now the question is that what is the ultimate aim of life? The ultimate aim of life is to get rid of suffering through vidya. And vidya is the root cause of suffering. And there are three types of sufferings according yoga philosophy, yoga darshan. These are parinam, tap and sanskar. Parinam dukh are the result of adhyatmik, adhibhautik and adhidevik sufferings or dukhas. And the next one is adhibhautik. These are adhyatmik dukhas are the resulted from manas and sharir due to the imbalance of trigunas and tridoshas. And this is very important to understand that we can control the adhyatmik dukhas through the practice of yoga nidra. And the second one is adhibhautik dukh due to other creatures, we can feel it. But it is very important to understand that we can get rid from these sufferings through the practice of yoga nidra. When we do the regular practice, we can get rid from all these sufferings. So the third one is adhidevik. This is very important to understand that due to natural disasters like earthquakes and floods, etc., we can feel this type of suffering. That is adhidevik. This is the game of manas. Totally, this is the game of manas, and we can get rid from all these kinds of dukhas through the practice of manas, through the practice practicing yoga nidra. And we should be aware about the conscious one, and we should be aware about our pure consciousness, our Atman, our Brahman. This is very important, and yoga nidra leads toward personally, towards physical health, psychological health and spiritual well-being, and which is academically helpful for own career, academic performances and guidance, and socially we will be helpful for the nation. We will be helpful for the society, human being and humanity, and we will lead toward the welfare of society, welfare of human being, welfare of world. And this is called Lok Sangha in Gita Darshan. So this is very important to practice. Regular practice of yoga nidra helps a person to come out from dukkha, emotional imbalances, dilemma, stress, tension, depression, personal and social imbalances, misunderstanding, aggression, violence, etc. Now, this is the time to understand the benefits of yoga nidra, the solution. This is the solution of psychophysical disease. I can say that sleeplessness is a major problem during this age, and we are suffering, we are facing this sleeplessness, and we feel work pressure, we feel there are so many problems in our life, and we can face these problems practicing yoga nidra. And 30 minutes of practice of yoga nidra is equal to 3 hours and 30 minutes deep sleep. This is very important to know that 30 minutes practicing yoga nidra is equal to 3 hours and 30 minutes deep sleep. And I'm not saying this. Studies are saying this. Our literature is saying this. So it is very important to practice yoga nidra, and we should be relieved from mental stress and tension through this, and we can get a sharp memory. And we will lead ourselves toward the positive thinking, new knowledge. And this is very important to understand that we can get freedom from drugs, wine, and other addictions too. Because this is I can say that the youth are facing the problem of drug addiction, wine, etc. during these days. So we can face, we can make a solution through the practice of yoga nidra, and this is very important to practice yoga nidra. So we can get a solution through the chitta vritti nirodha. There are five vrittis: avidya, asmita, raag, dvesh, and avinivesh are the clist vrittis of our chitta. And avidya is to deal the anitya as nitya, ashuchi as shuchi, dukha as sukha, and apunya as punya. And when we will be in vidya, in the situation of vidya, when we get vidya, then we can be a pure conscious one. We will be atmavata sarvabhuteshu parishamna samacharet. It is a quotation of a Sanskrit shloka, atmavata sarvabhuteshu parishamna samacharet. So this is very important that we will be free from all kind of suffering through yoga nidra, and we will be conscious about our pure self and who am I. And we can also get a very, very pleasant life, very healthy life, very blissful life. And this, you know that sukhanushayi raga and dukhanushayi dvesha. जो राग के साथ साथ चलता है, सुख के साथ जो चलता है वह राग है, और द्वेष के साथ जो चलता है वह द्वेष है. और इस राग और द्वेष से जब when we will be free from all these kinds of सुख and दुख, राग and द्वेष, then we will be free from all kind of suffering, and we will not get any fear of death. And these are the वृत्तिज जो हमें निरंतर दुखी करती हैं कि अब मेरे पास ये नहीं है, अब वो नहीं है, इस प्रकार से हम दुखी होते रहते हैं. तो योग निद्रा जो है वो हमें इन सारी चीजों से मुक्ति दिलवा सकती है, व्यावहारिक स्तर पर भी और आध्यात्मिक स्तर पर भी. बस आवश्यकता इतनी है कि वी शुड प्रैक्टिस इट रेगुलरली, एंड वी शुड ऑप्ट द वे ऑफ योग निद्रा फॉर अवर फिजिकल, mental and spiritual well-being, health, happiness, and kaivalya. These are the words for the day. And if you want to ask anything, welcome you all. If you want to ask something, or if there are any queries, please welcome. Sir, you are not audible, sir. Sir, you are not audible, sir. Professor Arya, sir.
Hello, hello. Am I audible? Yes.
Now audible. Now good.
Yes, thanks so much, Madam Dr. Kavita Bhatt, for your excellent presentation on Bhavatita Dhyana and Yoga Nidra. In spite of the unpleasant situation happened in your family, you have approved your commitment for academic deliberation and for the larger interest of the academician. Today you have very beautifully made a conceptual clarification of Bhavatita Dhyana and Yoga Nidra. And you have also shown how the regular practice of Yoga Nidra may lead to the physical health, mental health, spiritual well-being, and welfare of society, as well as to lead a blissful life. Thanks so much, madam. Now, over to Dr. K. Umnar now for the interactive session.
Thank you so much, you all, for patience hearing. And I think it was not so quiet. But it was my lecture was not so quiet because I have some disturbances and some
difficulties. No, it was very excellent. And very conceptual clarification of
the concepts. Thank you so much to listen me. Thank you.
Okay, now over to Dr. K. Umnar Rao to carry on the interactive session.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, Dr. Kavita Bhatt, for your nice lecture on Yoga Nidra. Well, it was a well-framed lecture. Well, I would like to request Professor Ghose to make his observations.
Thank you, Dr. Rao. We have listened very a very nice lecture by Dr. Kavita Bhatt, even if she is in an emotional stress at the moment because of the accident of her husband. And we all wish him to get well soon. So,
Thank you, sir.
So the thing is, in Yoga Nidra, what I have understood that it is a state of consciousness between waking and sleeping, right?
Yes.
So,
yes.
It is definitely different from the ordinary type of meditations that we undertake. So,
yes,
so can we just take it as a specialized form of meditation in a sleep posture, or
yes, maybe, there are the postures of Padmasana, Vajrasana, and other meditative poses are there, which we sit down and our spine should be straight during the meditation. This is the basic difference between meditation and or Dhyana and Yoga Nidra. This is the basic difference. We should be aware about our consciousness in both of these. But we should sit down in a meditative or Dhyanatmak pose or Dhyanatmak asana during the Dhyan. And in Yoga Nidra, we are in Savasana. We practice Savasana first of all, and then we should be aware about our pure self, about our Atman, Brahman during the Yoga Nidra. This is the basic difference.
Yeah.
And others are also. There is a Chalat Drishya Darshan, and there is a moving of consciousness, Mansik Nadi Shodhan are also there, which is a difference, which is a different step of Yoga Nidra. But in Dhyanatmak Sthiti or in Dhyanatmak situation, we focus ourselves, we focus our consciousness, our Purusha on our Agya Chakra or other chakras. But in Yoga Nidra, we practice the moving of consciousness in different points of our personality. This is the difference. So these two differences are major differences. And others are, I think...
Yes. You are very nicely...
Bahinyas and Antanyas. These are the differences.
Right. You have very nicely tried to put forth a philosophical foundation of this Yoga Nidra by relating these concepts, Anandamaya, Turiya, and Sushupti, Samadhi, all these concepts. Brings the foundational structure of Yoga Nidra, as far as I have understood from your
lecture. Thank you, sir.
Is it so? Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ghose and Dr. Kavita Bhatt. Well, I don't see any question in the chat box. If somebody wants to raise any question, they are welcome. Let us wait for half a minute. If anybody is interested for raising any question, they can unmute and directly ask the question to Dr. Bhatt. But we have some time before somebody unmutes. Well, I want to know from you, madam, how do you distinguish between Yoga Nidra and Nidra? We all have Nidra. and how to distinguish between yoga nidra and nidra. Is the nidra
yes.
that we have
yes, yes, yes.
yoga idea.
Yeah, as Professor Mahapatra said, that this is the situation, this is the condition between, this is the stage between awakening and sleeping. And sleeping is sleeping. We are not aware of, about anything during the sleeping. But in yoga nidra, we should be aware about everything, every point of our body, every point of our personality during the yoga nidra. This is the difference.
Thank you. Thank you, madam. So element of consciousness runs forth in yoga nidra. Thank you, madam. During the talk, you are making a reference to the sankalpas. Whether
yes.
I need to know whether this sankalpas, by sankalpas, you mean a sort of positive thinking? Is it? Whether this
sankalpas positive thinking is there, and this is basically a variety of pleasures to ourselves that I'll do it, I'll be happy, I'll be healthy, I'll be positive. I'll be blissful. I'll be a nice one. These are the sankalpas. And when we repeat these things, we will be able to get these things. When we repeat that I'm healthy, then I'll be healthy. When we repeat that I'm happy, I'll be happy. This is really the nice game of our consciousness, our manas. So, we should repeat this.
It is like, as I think, so I become. Oh, okay.
Yes, yes. Yes. Exactly, sir. You made the.
Hello, Dr. Kavita. This is Amit
yes.
here. Yeah. I
yes,
wanted
ma'am.
To ask, is yoga secular in nature?
As I told that this is a heritage of ancient Indian culture, but we can practice it beyond the religion, community and race, because it is a good practice. So we can do it, we can practice it for our good. So this is beyond the religion, I think.
Yes, it. I mean, this has to be recreated again and again in our communities, because somewhere or the other, this idea of framing and putting boundaries around the culture of yoga is very harmful to society, I feel. So this point particularly has to be recreated again and again in the society.
That's why I have repeated during my talk, I have repeated it again and again, that this is the practice which we can do for our good, and we should practice it beyond the religion, race and community. But it is an innovation of Indian culture, but we can practice it beyond the religion, culture and race. Matlab, when we are in America, we should practice yoga nidra. We will be get benefited. This is beyond the countries.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I'd like to add that since it is a product of our Sanatan Dharma, the practice. So this itself is secular in nature, because the Sanatan Dharma itself is a secular one, somebody admits it or not. But it is a part of our culture.
Yes, Dharma, there is a big difference between religion and Dharma. As everybody knows, that there is a big difference between religion and Dharma. Dharma is a way of life. The Sanatan Dharma is a way of life. This is not a particular one. This is beyond the, this is the well-being of, this is for the well-being of humanity. This is the well-being of human being. So why we can say that this is from these and why? I think so. This is the art of life. This is the way of life. And we should do it for our good, our well-being.
Absolutely. And thank you, even though you being in a difficult situation, you managed Salute to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Somewhere I have learned that yoga nidra is also treated as a psychic sleep.
Yes, of course.
Then what's the meaning?
But you can say that it's a psychic sleep. This is a newer one. This is a recent one. And the psychotherapists are regularly using the word psychic sleep. But the word is exactly yoga nidra. Because psychic sleep is, psych is manas. This is not, psych and manas jo hai, ye dono alag cheeze hain. Bilkul alag hain. Manas and my mind are not similar. There is a big difference between manas and psych. Psych is atma. Psych is that is, but I think that yoga nidra is the exact word for this, and psychotherapists are regularly using the psychic sleep word. But I already said and repeated again and again that this is the innovation of ancient Indian culture, ancient Sanatan Dharma. So the word yoga nidra is exactly not It should not be used like a psychic sleep.
Hello.
There is a difference.
Hello. I think psychic sleep is not the right term for it. Because you see, in psychic sleep, what happens? The suggestions is given by the psychotherapist. But here, what we do in yoga nidra, it is coming from within us. So we try to attain that state of consciousness.
Absolutely.
There is no external suggestion. Absolutely. It is internal. So it cannot be equated with psychic state.
Psychic.
Thank you.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you so much to make up the session. Thank you so much. I was too disturbed, and I think there was a disturbance. So thank you so much to help me. Thank you so much to support me nicely. Thank you again.
Thank you, Dr. Bhatt, for your response. One more thing. Well, we have some questions. Well, we'll take them. But two more questions we'll take. But prior to that, you are talking about sankalpa, and you said it's a sort of positive thinking. But again, I feel that sankalpa is so essential for yoga nidra, because it is a sort of positive vibration. Sankalpa
yes.
is a positive vibration on which the mind has to meditate repeatedly.
Yes.
It is only then yoga nidra is possible. Recently,
yes.
I was listening to a video by Shivani Sharma, a Brahma Kumari, who says, normally when we do a lot of work, we say we are tired. She says, no, it is a negative vibration. Never say like that. Maybe carrying a lot of work, but never say you are tired. You say, I am fresh. So when you say, I am fresh, the vibration around you will be so created that you will feel fresh. Don't say, I am busy. Maybe I am in a lot of work, don't say busy. You say, I am easy. When you say, I am busy, you feel easy, you feel comfortable. Okay. So that's how you create a positive vibration around you. So sankalpa is again what I feel, because mind has to repeatedly. Because when you make a sankalpa, when you say a sankalpa of this sort, I am busy. That means the sankalpa is you are busy. So you cannot take yourself forward. So yoga nidra is not possible. So yoga nidra is a sort of positive vibration.
Yes, of course.
Instead of saying I am busy, you say I am
absolutely right. You are absolutely right.
Madam. So it's a positive vibration. Sankalpa is a sort of positive vibration. Without that positive vibration, we cannot have even sleep. So we have to forget about yoga nidra. So for yoga nidra, a positive vibration is required on which mind has to repeatedly focus on, is only then we can have a sort of yoga nidra. Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Yes.
And one question let us take before we end up this session. It is by somebody, NS. He wants to try to see how do you relate hypnotism with the yoga nidra. How do you relate
hypnotism? Is also another thing. And we get supported with the psychotherapist during the hypnotism. But yoga nidra is a different thing. As Professor Mahapatra said, that this is a self one. This is a self practice. But hypnotism, there is an involvement of a psychotherapist during the hypnotism, or a psychologist. We get help from psychologists, but during yoga nidra, this is a self practice, self analysis. So this is the difference between these both.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Well, he is Professor Ranjit Ghosh, madam. So he is not Professor Mahapatra. He is Professor Ranjit Ghosh, and
yes, Professor Ranjit. Thank you.
Thank you for the response. Well, nicely done. Nicely responded. Let me move to. I don't see any questions. Let me check. I don't see any question. There are some wishes that your husband gets well soon. So one more. It's by Manoranjan Sahu. Despite traumatic emotional breakdown, madam, will you have a well? Well, thank you, madam. Thank you for your nice
thank
talk.
Thank you so much, sir. And philosophy family is supporting me, wishing me for good. Thank you so much, you all, to wish me for a good health of my husband. Thank you so much, you all. And philosophy family is my family, really. I feel so happy again and again to come with you people. And it was a nice meeting with you people. So I have delivered. I tried my best, but it was a breakdown. So thank you so much for patient hearing. And we will meet again soon.
I am sorry for that.
कोई बात नहीं, अब आपसे मुलाकात हो गई है तो फाइन हो जाएंगे सब.
I have a compliment for you.
Thank you for your good wishes. Thank you to invite me for this talk.
You proved yourself today by delivering a beautiful, wonderful talk. Which is better than the previous talk. Far better. It was far better than the previous talk. That does not mean that the previous talk was bad, but it was better. So both the talks were same. The talk on music and spirituality, and the talk on Bhavatit Dhyana and yoga nidra. There are two topics, but the theme was same, as I understood. So far the first talk was concerned, I shall tell that music is always incomplete. That is, music is not a human possibility. Music is not created by man. This is a very wrong conception, misconception. Music is there in nature. Music is the divine glory. If we do not see the glory of the manifestation of the divine, then we can see it through music, because there is rhythm in everything. There is rhythmic vibration in everything. Therefore, we feel each other. Therefore, we understand each other. Therefore, we have communication. Therefore, music is always incomplete. It is incomplete because every composition is an attempt to reach that rhythmic stance. Therefore, music is not noise. Music is not even sound. Music is silence. It is silence because there are 1,000 types of language. We do not understand the language of other community, but we understand the music. That means music transcends language. Suppose I don't understand the Tamil language, but I feel that spirituality, I get that feeling from that music, even I don't understand the language. That means music is the prana, that is the energy. That is silence in that sense, it transcends all language. And it is an attempt to meet that silence. Similarly, Yoganidra is a state of silence. Yoganidra is a state of silence. Yoganidra does not mean sleeping. Neither it is physical sleeping, nor it is psychological sleeping, even it is not spiritual sleeping. It is not sleeping anyway, though we use the word nidra. It is the state of silence where we are completely aware of everything. We are completely aware of every possibility. We are completely aware of the opposites, contradictions, thesis, antithesis. That is the state of silence. No aspect of our existence is ignored. That is the state of a yoga nidra. That means we have to reach that state of silence. Silence is a very beautiful term. That we ordinarily understand silence, that is not silence. Not speaking is not silence. We don't speak, but we are very much disturbed in our minds. Our mind is thoughtful. Silence means we have to be thoughtless. No thought can disturb us. So music and yoga both are secular. Both transcend all discriminations and both meet at the silence. That is the silent state. And music is the final product of spiritual sadhana. Music is the final product of spiritual sadhana, and that is a sense of beauty, sense of ecstasy, sense of imam, sense of identification in music. Therefore, when we speak of lyrics means language. So lyrics is not music. Music is something through which we have a poem, we have lyrics. That is the language part. But the composition, the music is something different. We impose that music, that means the higher level of consciousness is imposed on this lyric, therefore it becomes music. So the lyric part, the language part is not music. The singing part is not music. The sound, the noise, that is not music. Music is the feelings. Music is that sense of identification. When one is the lower is identified with the higher. Therefore, music is bhakti sadhana. It is not jnana sadhana, it is bhakti sadhana. Similarly, yoga nidra is jnana sadhana. Jnana sadhana means, so in bhakti sadhana, the ultimate is silence. In jnana sadhana also, the ultimate is silence. Silence is the confluence of all possibilities where we are comfortable about all possibilities and we are aware of all possibilities. That is a very comfortable stage for the yogi, those who have practiced spirituality, those who practice spiritual sadhana for a long time. They attain this stage. they appear to sleep, but that is not the state of sleep. That is the state of a complete awareness. That is the state of complete awareness. So those who are the music directors, they people call them mad person. A philosopher is also a mad person, because they are not physically mad. They are mad after that identity. They are mad after that identity. So that madness is required. So all the music directors are mad in that sense. Similarly, all yogic personalities are mad in that sense. So they live in their own world. So the vibration of the music director, when they compose a music, that reaches the heart and mind of every individual because of the force of that vibration. That vibration is so rich, so vibrant, so deep, that touch the heart of each and every individual, though they understand or don't understand the language. So music has no jati, music has no dharma, religion, no country, no boundary. Therefore, in the happiest moment we sing, in the saddest moment we sing, in the romantic moment we sing. That means in every possibility we are identified with the music. Music means nature. Music means that rhythm of the nature. That means music is the proof. Music is the proof which proves that we are all identical. Plants, animals, human beings, this nature, we are all identical. So when we fail to see the divine glory of manifestation, that divine glory of manifestation is reflected through the composition of music. Therefore, that is appreciated by devatas. Because that is the manifestation of the divine. And Yoga Nidra is an attempt, or it is a state of that silence. Silence means it is something beyond all discriminations, all types of discriminations. That means that is the complete awareness of my Jagrata, Supna and Susupti. When I am awake, then I am only waker. When I dream, then I am only a dreamer. When I am in the deep sleep, I am a sleeper. But in the Yoga Nidra, I am aware of my waking state, my dream state, my dreamless sleep state. I am aware of. And that is the secret of meditation. So Yoga Nidra is the highest form of meditation. I understand this personally. If anything wrong, madam will say. Thank you.
Hello. I just one thing came to my mind, that only one sentence. As COVID is a physical contagion, music is an emotional contagion. Okay, so we can say that music is having no boundaries, as Professor Das said right now. And regarding Yoga Nidra, we can exemplify today is Ananta Chaturdashi. So Ananta Vishnu Ananta Sayanam. So that is the perfect example of Yoga Nidra. That is what these two things came to my mind. That's why I referred. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ghosh, for adding up at last. Okay. Thank you very much, and thank you, Professor Das. Well, the real end of music or even yoga nidra, this silence, the end of all, may it be music or yoga nidra, both of them lead to silence. And if they are not, then there is no music, there is yoga, there is no yoga nidra. So if you are finding a silence within, then you are success in your musical life, you are success in yoga nidra. Thank you. Over to Professor Kailas Mana sir for carrying on the further.
Thanks so much, Professor Das, for making a very beautiful synthesis of music, philosophy, and your yoga. And it is, you know, that music is also Bhavatita. And once upon a time, you are in the speaks that do your sadhana through music, do your yoga with music. Thanks so much, Professor Das and Professor Anjit Ghosh. And now over to Professor Dr. K. Umar now to propose a hearty vote of thanks to our speaker, Professor Tapan Chakraborty, Dr. Bhatt, Professor Anjit Ghosh, Professor Seshadri, and all others who are with us. Over to Dr. Rao.
Thank you, Dr. Maharana, for calling me again for proposing a formal vote of thanks. Well, I should say that today both the talks are very interesting, they're very beautiful. Dr. Tapati Chakraborty tried to bring in a sort of equation between music and philosophy, as Professor Dr. Ghosh rightly pointed out that that she in her lecture tried to translate music as a sort of philosophy and and then paving it towards paving it to have a spiritual journey. So very nicely done, madam. We are really benefited by your talk, and I should also thank the second speaker, Dr. Kavita. In spite of the problems at home, but she consistently could deliver her talk so consistently, and the responses were also so nice and beautiful. So I should thank both the speakers for their talks and the responses that they had from the observations and the questions that were raised during both the sessions. So I thank both the speakers once again. I should thank Professor Dr. Rajit Ghosh sir for being connected with philosophy family. His questions, his observations raise a lot of issues for discussion. So I should thank him, because he is the real force who literally brings in a lot of vibration into the entire discussion, and that's how his presence makes the discussion so lively. And we are really fond of you, sir. We want to always be in the family, so that you can raise beautiful issues, you can make nice observations. So we are learners, we can learn from you. Okay, thank you very much, sir, for your presence and for raising so beautiful questions and making so sincere, very nice and sincere observations. Thank you so much, sir. I should thank all the question writers for being connected and raising questions, and also thank our admin, Professor Pramod Das, for making this webinar possible, and also making his own observations, and also thank Dr. Kailas Mahana sir for his coordination of this event, and also having his own observations during the course of the webinar. So, well, there are other Professor Seshadri, Professor Valmiki, and many others. They have raised issues, they have raised questions, they have made observations, and all others, even Sravani Mishra, and all others, even Subhashini Barik is there today with us. And I should thank all the participants who are connected with this webinar and philosophy family, the activities of philosophy family. So I thank all of them for their presence in Sunday webinars, and I request all of them to be connected with philosophy family, so that our aim of learning from each other becomes really possible and becomes successful. So we are all learners, and we wish to learn from each other, and that's the basic motto of philosophy family. And I request the participants to make their observations whenever time comes, so that we can learn from each other, and we can make philosophy family a place for interaction and sharing of ideas with each other. So thanking everybody connected with this, I move to Professor
Kailash Maharana to Kailendra Pathipas. I thank everybody for being connected with this webinar and Philosophy Family. Thank you, everybody.
Okay, thanks so much, Dr. Rao, for the beautifully moderating the session and for making your observation and proposing a nice vote of thanks. Now, okay, Dr. Okay, Kavita ma'am. Kavita ma'am. Hello, Kavita ma'am. Are you with
us? No, she has left. She has left.
Okay. We all the members of Philosophy Family pray before the Almighty for the speedy recovery of sir. Okay. And
madam is here.
Madam Kavita Bhatt. Madam Kavita Bhatt. Hello. Do you listen to me?
Yes.
Okay. We all the members of Philosophy Family pray before the Almighty for the speedy recovery of your husband.
Thank you so much, sir. My family. You all are supporting me. You all are wishing me. Thank you all. Thank you so much again and again, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, mute. Sir, unmute, sir. You are muted.
Now over to Professor Pramod Kumar Das for the closure of the meeting.
Yes. So this is time to close. So before closing, I shall just ask Dr. Kavita Bhatt, madam. Madam, did you agree with my points?
Yes, sir. Of course. I'm totally agree with you, and you have analyzed very well. You made up the station, sir. Thank you so much
for this night.
Yes,
and your husband will get soon, very soon.
Thank
get
you,
well
sir.
Very soon. Because our family is so big, so the bigger family will have the greater blessings from all corners.
Thank you, sir.
Nothing will happen to you. Anyway.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Tapati madam is also here.
Yes.
So the Philosophy Family is grateful to both of you for your dedication. And this is the real commitment of a philosopher. So we are studying philosophy, but we should learn to be a philosopher in life. So to become a philosopher, we have to meet so many challenges of life. So this year, today's moment was a challenging moment. And in spite of that, you did better than your previous talk. This is my very, very honest remark and compliment to you.
We do agree with you, Professor Das.
Thank you. With this, this meeting is declared closed. Thank you.
Now may I leave, sir?
Yes, ma'am.